EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it is all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the NFC champions, the San Francisco 49ers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we don't like to throw around the word dynasty loosely, but for the Chiefs, it applies. I mean, they're looking for their third title now in 5 years.
And with the way this league is configured now, it absolutely applies. I think you're totally on target. Remember, they lost the Super Bowl.
The 2023 season has one game left. Here we go. Super Bowl 58 underway from Vegas. This fielded right at the goal line. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Here's the Chiefs offense for their first possession, and it's Patrick Mahomes at quarterback.
And he spoke very eloquently and passionately on media day about what a victory here would mean for him. He knows this just isn't any other game. This is the kind of game that stays with you for a lifetime. If there's anyone on this field tonight who's most ready for this moment, I think it's this man right here.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Throwing at the outset, here's Mahomes. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. Getting this just shy of midfield. They'll spot it at the 49. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
And they'll employ the jumbo set now on second and one. Now Mahomes on the bootleg. Open man is the tight end, Noah Gray. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 24-yard line. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit. And another first down.
The first drive here and the first time that we've called a big tight end's name. But I can assure you this, Charles, it won't be the last.
No, it won't, because when he gets going, now it opens up opportunities on the perimeter, because that'll draw the defense towards him in the middle of the field. Now your wide receivers will get involved as this game goes on.
On first down, Mahomes. The tight end, Kelce, has it over the middle. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Boy, no problems getting down the field here on this opening drive. They've looked really sharp in the early going, and they've come up with some big plays already. Here's another. That's going to set up first and goal.
Here's Mahomes to throw. Now a swing pass. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal. Throwing now is Mahomes. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play, and that'll bring up a third down and goal. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Toward the pylon, caught, and in for the Chiefs touchdown. Marquez Valdes-Scantling bringing in that one from Patrick Mahomes. And the Chiefs are on the board first here in this Super Bowl.
That was a big throw right there on third and goal.
And the defense has to be prepared for you to throw the ball on third and goal. Because really, second down, second and goal, that's your play action time, and you're not sure whether they're going to run it or throw it. Third down, you're usually sure they're probably going to pass it. Even more impressive that they got it done and on the opening drive of the game.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he returns this to the 22. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. Leading them out, someone who took the league by storm last year is the most famous Mr. Irrelevant ever. From Iowa State, it's Brock Purdy.
And there are a lot of quarterbacks who had terrific careers. Think about guys like Phillip Rivers, Randall Cunningham, Dan Fouts, Warren Moon. But they never got to a Super Bowl. Yet here he is in his second NFL season, already getting his chance. And we harken back to Dan Marino, another superstar, made it in his second year, lost the game, and never made it back again.
The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
And he's going to have a Niners first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Powering his way forward. And that's just a solid, good physical run there as he motors for 9 yards. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
On second down, McCaffrey. And the ball is knocked out. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
Even though he recovered his own fumble, you know how much he hates to put the ball on the ground. He's going to be frustrated with himself.
And what do you think the time frame was from the time the ball escaped his grasp to him getting it back? It didn't take that long, right?
Right.
To him, it probably felt like hours because he's agonizing, like, I've got to get this football back. Able to get it done.
And shifts past him. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
58 yards rushing for him now on their opening drive of the Super Bowl.
Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10.
This time they'll throw it. Here's Purdy.
Hauled in left side here by Jennings. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And that's going to bring up second down.
Throwing here, Purdy. Complete to the tight end, Kittle, over the middle of the field. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
On 3rd down, it's Purdy. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
You absolutely have to have this early on, right? 3rd and short, they elect to throw for it, and that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on 3rd and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there.
And this may be a big early turning point in this Super Bowl. They're going to go for it on 4th down here. But he has the 1st down before he's tackled at the 5.
There wasn't even thought of a short field goal. There was no hesitation. They were going for it.
I think he was thinking ahead a couple plays ago that if he got in this situation, they were definitely going for it. And you're right. It was a confident call and a decisive run to pick it up.
1st and goal and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. Powerful running. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal. They're mounting a nice drive here. Good chunk of yardage there again. O-line, they've been solid this drive.
They have that look about them right now that says, if you do anything but run the ball behind us, you're crazy. They have really moved it well on this drive, and they want to finish it off the same way.
And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. A 2nd down play results in a loss of 2 yards.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
They'll look to throw on 3rd and goal. And it's caught by Deebo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the 49ers are an extra point away from tying this Super Bowl at 7.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Moody good with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So that drive, 12 plays in length.
And it's Deebo Samuel who caps things with a touchdown reception. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. And Kansas City's offense now set and ready to go. As this offense takes the field again, it's been a while since they've been out there. We just saw that long touchdown drive by the opposition. But remember, when this crew was out here last, Charles, they scored as well.
And let's make sure we give both offensive staff some credit, and especially the offensive coordinators, because we spoke with both of them in the lead up to this game, and both were really confident in their game plans. They felt like they had scouted their opponents and focused on specific areas in practice this week to make sure that they were ready to go. And frankly, it looks like they both did an excellent job.
And we'll see if those game plans can keep this streak of touchdowns going here.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That brings us to the end of one in Super Bowl 58. Much more to come from Las Vegas after this. 7-all is the score. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Pacheco. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Mahomes to throw on second down. Well, this one complete. It's Rashee Rice.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
2 yards still to go. Third down now. They'll bring the tight end in motion right here. On third down, it's Pacheco. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They go play fake. Mahomes. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Second and 10. Mahomes now to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Rice. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 42. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Play action. Now it's Mahomes. That's taken in by Watson.
Parnay sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go. Let's see who's faster.
In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Open on the left side. This is Valdez-Scantling. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. This will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. To Valdez-Scantling over the middle. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They run it with Pacheco from the gun. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down.
That solid gainer will put them on the doorstep of the end zone. More importantly, it gives them a fresh set of downs. Nice work right there.
So another third down conversion, and now they've got a first and goal. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And he's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Kadarius Toney from 3 yards out, and the Chiefs have taken the lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Butker on for the PAT. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it's Kadarius Toney who caps things with a touchdown reception. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
So that time, they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
McCaffrey running up the middle. And he'll be taken down at the 18. There for the tackle was Trent McDuffie.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Purdy now on second down. Connects with Kittle underneath. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. So 5 yards here, five on the play. Third and seven now.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Purdy with it on third and long. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Trent McDuffie getting the chance to blitz and finishing it off with a sack. How about that? The defense's first sack. It doesn't come from one of the usual suspects up front. It comes from the secondary.
Yeah, I think they caught the quarterback off guard a little bit because he wasn't able to account for the possibility of that blitz and change the blocking assignment. He comes through and puts him on the ground.
That'll be a 41-yard punt, 4 yards there on the return. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. And now here comes Kansas City. Now right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 43. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That'll be caught by Rice. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
I tell you what, if this is any quarterback other than Patrick Mahomes, I'm telling you how this is an ill-advised throw. But 15 is so good on the move with all those different arm angles and releases. then all I'm saying now is that's a gorgeous play.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. That is incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Mahomes. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
I can put just a little bit too much heat on that one. When you throw it to the outside, you do have to be careful because you got to keep it away from the defender. But you also have to give your own guy a chance, too.
The Chiefs on third down. A perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A nice pickup of 23 on the third down conversion.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Mahomes to throw once more. That one caught by Rice. A gain of 8 there on the play. And it'll be second and a couple. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. 2 yards left on second down from the 9. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the Chiefs are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up the first down.
Mahomes going to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Well, we've seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
Throwing now is Mahomes. Now a swing pass. It's Edwards-Helaire. Touchdown! Clyde Edwards-Helaire from 3 yards out. And the Chiefs continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl. Well, just a sensational start for this offense, Charles. 3 drives, 3 passing touchdowns.
Is that like mentioning a perfect game in baseball? Or are we cool to do it here in football, partner?
No, I think you can do it here in football. I think perfect game in baseball, that's its own category.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. Could not imagine a worse start for that secondary. Or let's face it, a better one for this offense. No chance they stop passing now the way that it's going. I think they'll continue to press the ball downfield and hopefully reap the same results.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field.
And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp. And at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
On first down, it's Purdy.
Hauled in left side here by Jennings. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
Purdy looking to throw.
Over the middle, complete to Samuel. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Purdy.
That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and it's second down. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half.
From the 44 now, here's second and 4. Once more, Purdy looking to throw.
And his throw is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down.
Throwing here, Purdy.
That is taken down, a Chiefs sack. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one.
So on fourth down, here's the Australian native Mitch Wishnowsky to punt this one away.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10.
They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3.
So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcoming everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. The highlights are fairly one-sided to this point. It's a 2-touchdown difference here at the break. But I wouldn't call this one over just yet. I think there could still be some fireworks yet to come.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number 3.
These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl.
And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. The 49er offense set to go to begin quarter number 3.
Well, in the first half, they struggled a little bit to keep pace offensively, CD, down two scores here. So how do they make some changes coming out of the locker room?
Well, they've studied what they did in the first half. They've seen what the defense has thrown at them. Now they want to have a plan of attack against it. So you come out, you're not going to get all the points back on one drive, but get started on it. Start chopping into that lead, and maybe it'll inspire your defense to help out as well.
Purdy's throw complete here to Ayuk. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. McCaffrey following the penalty. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Second and 15. Purdy now to throw. Pass caught by Ayuk on the slant. That'll give him 8 that time. Third and 7 now.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Here's Purdy now on third and goal. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Well, if they have any designs of getting back into this football game in the second half, they're going to need to be much sharper offensively than they were on this opening possession. Not much happening here, and it'll lead to a fourth down.
Here comes the 49ers punter now as he's on to kick it away. They bring the pressure as he gets this one away. Fair catch called for and made, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense.
What did I think then?
That hurts. If it was running into the kicker, wouldn't be a first down. Roughing, it is a first.
And just think about the differences between the two. Running into the kicker almost feels inadvertent, just a small tap, so to speak. But when you rough him, usually bodies are hitting the ground and flying all different places. And the difference is 5 yards or 15. And in this case, that's a big play.
So a big break. The roughing the kicker called on fourth down leads to first and 10. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the 44-yard line, here's second down and 7. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And some space. And he loses the football a second time. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Second time he's fumbled in this game. Fortunate for him, this one goes out of bounds.
And the key for him now is how much equity have you built up with your coaching staff? How much equity have you built up with your team to continue to get opportunities? Fortunate that one went out of bounds. Saved him from a turnover.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Purdy. George Kittle. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
McCaffrey will score. Touchdown, 49ers.
Well, we talked a lot about Christian McCaffrey and what he can do in the open field, and it's easy to gloss over how tough he can be to stop near the goal line. And he shows you just how tough he is on that carry as he takes it into the end zone.
An extra point try now for Moody.
It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And the last play on the drive, the touchdown run from Christian McCaffrey.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away.
And we see James, he will not return it, and they'll bring it out to the 25. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number two.
And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
They'll start the drive here with Pacheco.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. To throw, it's Mahomes. Able to get away, dancing to his left. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guys couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He doesn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last laugh by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
They'll try for the first with Pacheco.
And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on 4th.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Here's the Chiefs punter now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. This is taken at the 15.
A nice return there of 11 to help mitigate a good punt.
And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. Pretty solid on that last drive. Yardage good, 4 carries, and it all culminated with that 1-yard touchdown run.
And believe it or not, I try to further my football education all the time, so I was reading a book about offensive line play, and right out of the first chapter, the word leverage. That's what jumped up. Low man wins. Who gets off the ball faster creates that space for the runner, and that's exactly what they did.
Especially on that 1-yard push into the end zone that finished off that last drive.
And let's see if they can continue with that leverage on this drive.
Stopped and handed a loss by Willie Gay that time.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on 2nd and 13.
Out of the gun, Purdy connects with Kittle underneath.
Just a gain of a couple there. And that brings up 3rd and a full 10 yards.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Here's 3rd and 10. Purdy.
Looking deep for Jennings. And that's caught inside the 35. A big third down play there for the Niners. 44 yards.
Well, as my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Back to throw, Purdy. Got a man right side, it's McCaffrey. The excellent play last time is followed by a much more routine gain of 3.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Purdy will set up to throw it here. That one complete to his receiver, Jennings. 7 yards there and a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
Purdy looking to throw on first down here. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Purdy gets this one to Juszczyk. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 5, and that'll bring up 4th down.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
They'll run for it. McCaffrey. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. Christian McCaffrey unable to get to the marker, and the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop. Well, they knew who to turn to on 4th down, their horse. They needed the short yardage. He just couldn't get it.
And that's a surprise, because normally that's bread and butter for them, right? Hand it to the big guy, let him go, pick up the first down. Didn't get it there. All credit to the defense. Usually, even if they know he's coming, he can't be stopped, and they got it done on that play.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at their own 11. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. They'll check this one down to Pacheco. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. It'll go as a gain of 4, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
We are through 3 quarters of play here from Allegiant Stadium in Super Bowl 58. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. 2nd and 6. Folks, welcome back to the biggest stage in sports, the Super Bowl, and now we get down to the good stuff, the 4th and final quarter. And he'll be stopped right at the 30 on a play that started back at the 15. They pick up 15. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
49 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
They go play action. Now Mahomes. Short throw held in by Kelce. And Kelsey's going to have a Chiefs first down up near midfield, spotted at the 48.
They'll get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10.
Headed straight, it's Pacheco. And a pretty athletic run right there as he's going to get this down inside the 40.
That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Mahomes now on first down.
And that'll be caught by Tony.
He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is 2nd and 6. Pacheco gets it up the gun.
And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. Mahomes going to throw.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1.
He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on 3rd down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
On 1st down, Mahomes. Over the middle. That's caught by Rice. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Two yards to go, 2nd down.
Throwing now is Mahomes.
Now a swing pass, it's Edwards-Helaire.
And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves him with a 1st and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another 1st down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Chiefs are starting to pull away in the fourth quarter of this Super Bowl.
Well, that's certainly going to bump up the old win probability index, because now it's a 2-score game here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you're taking me into that deep water now. Win probability index. This game's definitely not over. We're not looking at a 0.5% or something. It's just 2 scores. But the way that this team has played, to me, what I've seen, they absolutely deserve to win this game. They've been the better team by far throughout.
Extra point by Butker is on target.
And the lead now up to 14.
Get something together.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25.
San Francisco's offense returns to the field. And we're at the time of this Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly, trailing here in the fourth quarter as they begin this drive first and 10. Purdy looking to throw. He'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he'll get this up past the 20. A second down throw for Purdy. And that one to the right side and incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. The Niners on third down, lacking much success. Just 2 for 7 to this point. This is 3rd and 7. Here's Purdy. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up 4th.
The frustration evident there because he couldn't find anyone on third down, and he left no doubt that he was throwing that one away.
If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. So they really needed points here in a 2-score game. Could not come away with anything there on 4th.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now really hoping for a turnover. On 1st and 10, here's Mahomes. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
Here's 2nd and 10. Mahomes now to throw. The tight end, Kelsey. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Travis Kelsey, his 2nd touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Chiefs are feeling good as they extend their lead in this Super Bowl. Well, this, of course, set up by the stop a moment ago on 4th down. And now that might be the score that puts this one officially out of reach.
And it's a tough one because your hands are tied when you're losing in the fourth quarter because you know you've got to make something happen. They couldn't pick up the 1st down, and after that, the air just went right out of the balloon, and you knew you were looking at a defeated team.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory as they have been outplayed tonight. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Complete to the tight end, Kittle, over the middle of the field.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Ball starts. Offense.
Oh. The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. The false start hurts him there a bit. Backs him up to second and nine. Now Purdy. They'll find Ayuk open right side. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. First down San Francisco to pick up 14 yards. Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where as coaches, you're looking for effort and execution even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Another miss. On his feet. Christian McCaffrey, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Niners have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Well, forget about the weapons out wide. He knows he's got another weapon in the backfield of the passing game, Charles, and he utilized him perfectly on that play.
And the offense coordinator showed me something on that play, Brandon, because so often during a game, our cameras find them looking down at their play sheets, and you wonder if they're absorbing anything. He had something specific in mind, and he went to it, and it worked well.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
They go play fake. Mahomes. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and take and go like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Pitch and catch here to Travis Kelce. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it'll be second down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll swing this out to Tony. This will be a short gain of three before he's brought down at the 22.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been excellent, 6 for 7. This time it's third and three. Mahomes to throw once more. And that will be incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. This to make it a three-score game late. Butker's kick here is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So after five touchdowns offensively, hey, maybe it's time to get the kicker a little work, and he's able to connect there.
I love that empathetic side of you. You're worried about him getting some action, getting to be a part of the game. Well, he got in and got it done.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And it's becoming more and more apparent that this is just not going to be their night. That Lombardi Trophy so close, but the expectations simply have not matched the results as they start on this drive, first and 10. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he will find his man, Samuel. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Purdy now to throw. Connects with Kittle underneath. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout. And all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays.
And the Chiefs are going to get him. Chris Jones, his second sack of the night.
How about that, partner? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had two sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only three have had the record number of three sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him.
Now Purdy. Called in left side here by Jennings. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 33. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Kind of a dangerous throw there. He's off balance when he gets rid of it. But this is all about a quarterback knowing what he can get away with. And that time, it turns into a completion and a healthy gain as well.
Purdy looking to throw on first down here. A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Now a second and 10. Purdy will set up to throw it here. And he can't escape, and down he goes. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Purdy looking deep for Jennings, and a penalty flag comes in as that one winds up incomplete, but the contact is going to move the ball well downfield.
So a costly penalty yardage wise as that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball, and if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
The throwing here, Purdy. And he hauls it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Juwan Jennings
a 7-yard touchdown grab.
And the Niners are able to cut into that deficit.
He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you? Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
So time definitely not in their favor. Down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. And now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. And the Kansas City Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. That actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.